Welcome in this yoga class for the back. So we will start on the back.
Lay down on the mat.
And we will just start by bringing the knees close to the chest and roll one side and the other side, like a little massage for the back. And from here, we will make some circle with the hands on the knees. On one direction and on the other direction. And from here, slowly, we will bring the outside of the feet and we will push the knees towards the mat, so towards the ground in a happy baby pose. So let the hips open and feel this area. And again, we can balance side to side to put one knee at a time on the floor. Breathe deeply here. And during all the classes, we want to connect with the breathing and we want to feel it in the abdomen. On every inhalation, we want to feel the abdomen full of air. And on the exhalation, the belly button towards the spine, all the air out. So in this state of mind, slowly we come back on the mat in the table pose. So from here, we make sure to stretch the spine. So inhale, we arch the back and look up. And exhale, round. Again, inhale. And exhale. And two times again. Follow your breath and connect with all the sensation of the body. Come back in a neutral posture. And from here, we want to try to connect the shoulders, the right shoulders with the right hip. And we do the same on the other side. So when you inhale, you're in the middle. And when you exhale, you squeeze one side. Back in your table pose, your back is neutral. And from here, we want to stretch the hand forward, the arms forward, and we come in the puppy pose. So first, your forehead will go on the floor. Make sure that your knees are aligned with your hips. And if it's possible, maybe the chin will go on the floor and maybe your chest will touch the floor. just maybe. Take your time and breathe deeply in this posture. Make sure that your exhalation is a little bit longer than your inhalation. So like that, we really go in a vibe where we allow the body to relax more. Three big breaths again here. And from here, roll your head and slowly we crawl in the baby cobra pose. And we stay here. Maybe you will be able to put your legs together. Maybe you will put your heels together. You open your shoulders. Engage your shoulders blade, your shoulder blade. Slowly engage the hands under the armpit and we come in the full cobra pose. And from here we will just turn one side and turn on the other side. Maybe you feel your digest system. Connect with the sensation of the body. Again, one time on each side. So maybe you feel that your arms are really engaged and slowly come back in your table pose. Yes. So from here, inhale, left arms towards the sky. And from here, bring this arm under the right arm. Here. So the left side of your body is engaged to the floor. And you extend your right arms. If you are comfortable in this posture, you can bring your right leg up. And breathe here. and slowly. Your two knees are grounded on the floor. You bring your hands close to your face, under your shoulders. You push into it. And you do the same on the other side. So let's do the other side. Inhale, right arm up to the sky. Exhale. This right arm goes under the opposite arm. Extend your left arms above your head. Make sure that your hips are always aligned with the knees. And from here, inhale if it's possible and bring your left leg up to the sky. Bring this leg down if it was in the air, and slowly come back in your table pose again. When you're ready, engage your toes and come in your downward dog. Take time to stretch one heel at a time towards the floor. One heel at a time towards the floor. Keep this posture for a moment. In the sitting position. So we will do the eagle arms because it's really good for the back. So we will start by putting the right arms under. So we bend and we cross the arm like this. If it's too much, we can do this. So we stay here with the eagle arms. And if we would like to go a little bit farther in this posture, there's an option. We can also bring the leg like this. So one knee on the other, if it's possible. Shoulder blades, one towards each other. Make sure that your elbows are aligned with your shoulders. So we don't want to be like that. We want to be like this. Sensation of your hair going out and coming in. And same thing on the other side. So we can switch the leg and the arms. Take all your time. So one goal of this class tonight is to relax this nervous system and have a good night of sleep. So this time it's the left arm under, and it's the left leg on. So again, shoulders far from the ears, engage the shoulder blades, and breathe deeply. Maybe you can breathe and bring an intention at the same time for your week, for your day. Imagine that your spine are really high to the sky, super extend. And slowly release, take your time. Sometimes it's intense, the posture. And from here, we will bring the hands on the shoulders and just take the time to make some circle in one direction. And on the other direction. So again, we will return on the mat. And we will go in the shoulder pose if it's something possible. Or there's an option because it's the night and we would like to be maybe more passive in the posture. We can use the wall and just let the leg like this and breathe. And after a moment, we can just open the leg and let the hips open. If not, you can just go in the full posture as you want. So in this case, you engage your leg and your hips. Up! And you breathe. If the posture is comfortable like this, you can bring a step farther. So you can cross your fingers and open your shoulders a little bit more on the floor. From here, slowly, you can bring your feet above the head. Make sure to maintain your back, only if it's possible. It's a really good stretch for the entire back and for the nervous system on each side of the spine. So again, here you can push in one heel at a time. Breathe deeply. If your feet touch the floor, you have the option to open the shoulders. Again, with your fingers crossed.
And slowly, vertebra by vertebra, come back on the floor. And we will slowly take a moment to just let the body release. And if the back is a little bit painful, you can just set your feet on the ground. And you can let your knees together. And breathe deeply here. Bring your neck on one side and on the other side. Right, left, left, right. Bring your knee to your knees to your chest and roll side to side. Take a moment here for breathing. And gently we will go in the fish pose. So we want to bring the arms completely under the body. Extend your feet. Inhale, look your toes. So your weight is on the forearms. Open the chest and put your heads on the floor. Slowly come back on the mat, and we will go in the twist. So from here we will simply bend the knees, legs together, and first we let the knees fall on the left side. On your exhalation, and your neck, your head, turn on the right side. Breathe deeply here, and really let your body relaxing. Let the shoulders release towards the floor. Your body come back in the center, align with your spine, your neck, your head, and your legs. And on your next exhalation, let your legs going on the left side and turn your head on the opposite direction.
the center. Again, knees towards the chest. Make all the adjustment that you need. Move your back instinctively on the floor. And slowly, you can go in your Shavasana. So, make sure to be really comfortable in this posture. Take the time to relax all your body parts. With this background Mexican music from my neighbor. Always on time for the Shavasana. Relax your toes, your ankles, your legs. Relax your hips. Relax your back. Relax your chest and your shoulders. Feel that all your lower body and all your upper body is relaxed. Relax. Relax. Relax your arms, relax your hands, relax your throat, your neck, all your body is relaxed. Even if it's full of weird noise around, find your inner peace. Your inner silence. Take a moment to move your fingers and your toes and roll on your right side. Push in your hand to come up. And thank you to take this time for yourself tonight.